Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We had an exciting launch during the week with liftoff of Axiom Space's AX-1 mission on Friday. The booster which launched to this mission, B-1062, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
As you can see, this Falcon 9 has landed for the fifth time. All the while, great commentary there.
The ISS posted a tweet saying four AX-1 astronauts from Axiom Space opened the SpaceX Dragon Endeavour hatch today at 10:13 a.m. Eastern Time, entered the station and met the seven-member Expedition 67 crew. There was a tweet posted saying today's AX-1 mission provides one of the best SpaceX Falcon 9 first stage landings as an uninterrupted time-lapse from the onboard camera. Musk responded with smooth video courtesy of bolting Starlinks to the deck. They are able to handle high vibration and acoustics. There was a tweet I wanted to share that SpaceX posted about this Axiom mission. They said, over the course of AX-1, the crew will conduct approximately 25 experiments focused on human research, life and physical sciences, technology demonstrations and Earth observations that will expand microgravity research to new sectors. NASA's Kennedy Space Center Twitter account posted an amazing picture of both Falcon 9 and SLS on launch pads. It says, "Welcome to America's multi-user spaceport." Seen here is SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket for AX-1 on pad 39A and our Artemis 1 rocket on 39B. This is the first time two different types of rockets and spacecraft made to carry humans are on the sister pads at the same time. I also wanted to share the upcoming launches as we have another launch expected this coming week. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the NROL 85 mission is scheduled to lift off on Friday 15th at 12:59 p.m. UTC or 8:59 a.m. EDT. There's a tweet from Everyday Astronaut that I want to share about a Netflix documentary focused on SpaceX. He said, "Netflix knocked it out the park for Return to Space with incredible access of NASA and SpaceX DM2. I had the honour of being part of it alongside Elon Musk, Jim Bridenstine, Bob Behnken, Doug Hurley and Gwynne Shotwell. I've personally seen the documentary and for those of you with Netflix, I highly recommend it. It's very inspiring." There was a CNBC article posted saying Sir Richard Branson, less than a year after reaching space with Virgin Galactic, hopes to next trade flights with Elon Musk and fly with SpaceX. He said, "Hopefully I'll be able to go up on one of his spaceships one day and he'll be able to go up on one of ours." SpaceX has secured yet more launch contracts with this article posted about another agreement. It says, "Momentus Inc., a US commercial space company that plans to offer transportation and other in-space infrastructure services, recently announced that it has signed multiple launch agreements with SpaceX." Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. New GSE plumbing was seen being installed on the orbital launch tower. The chopstick catching arms were seen raised to the top of the tower during testing. The Starship quick disconnect recently removed was seen moved back to the launch site. Foundation work has been spotted going on at SpaceX's little rocket garden. There is an article posted related to Boca Chica and a permit to expand their site in the area. It says the US Army Corps of Engineers has closed a permit application for a proposed expansion of SpaceX's Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas. A potential snag in the company's plans to add new launch and landing pads to the area as well as substantially grow the site. Here's a view of a booster header tank seen being placed on a truck in the yard. Ship 20 was seen being moved over to the suborbital pad B launch mount. Work continues on the Ship 24 nose cone in the yard. Here's the Ship 24 body section. Ship 24 is now continuing to progress inside the midbay. Both the Ship 24 nose cone and payload barrel section are waiting to be stacked. The two have now been stacked inside the high bay. Crews have continued working on Booster 7 as it sits on the orbital launch mount. Super Heavy Booster 7 was hooked up to the crane to be lifted. Booster 7 was then lifted off the orbital launch mount. Booster 7 has been placed on the structural test stand. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, after testing during the week, some closures have been added. There are currently closures scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 11th until Wednesday 13th for possible testing. Finally, to finish today's video, we once again have a Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.